Hello for Monday, June 25th, and it is the last trading week of the month and for the 6 month period. So maybe we can continue a rally that started on Friday a little bit and end the month strongly and go right back up. The number of lows have been going down, and that's good. So, and we've got a lot of stocks that have remained quite strong, mainly, especially the biotech pharma sector. So we've got several stocks on the watch list. They're all alongs. I know we had the market, some market weakness, but these particular stocks look strong. We don't have any market charts today. Check the newsletter, stocktiger.net, because we have loads of charts there. So we'll run through these pretty quickly. ARAY looks pretty good. Increasing volume on Friday. It was up big, so maybe it needs to consolidate a while. We're saying over 661. You can see it's closed over the 50 days, so somewhere between here and 661 was just a recent high over there. 676 was one. So to start off with, up to around this like $7 area, we'll see how it goes depending on the volume that comes in. But look, it's just started with the Williams getting back over the 80 line. So if this starts going, it has been basing a couple months, it may be starting a trend that could last a while. But the start is breaking of that line. Fuel cell. Remember, this is a low-priced one now, and it gets back over that. We're looking first if it pulls up here. I think it's around 112. Yeah, it was high the day was 111. So somewhere in there, it's got the 50-day at 114. So this is a hard call, but it had really increased volume, 5.9 million shares. It does that sometimes, and then pulls back. The last time at least had a couple days. So this can be a continuation Monday and a Tuesday. If it really gets going, look for resistance at 122. That's where I have it drawn. That was where the gap down was from, and that's also the 200-day EMA, so that would be a pretty good level if it goes from there. Another low-priced one is GEN, and this one is here, and you can see it broke above this trend line on with very big volume. On Friday had volume of slight volume, 79 million shares, and you can see normally its volume is underneath 20 million, so big volume. So if it gets above that 147, 150, we'll call it area because it got to 149. Then 155 is a 20-day, but the main thing is strong volume like this again, back over 150. This could then break above that 155, maybe go back up to the 173, even the 178. That's a 50-day EMA, but this volume. Big on it, and we'll see how it goes. We want big volume, of course, on the break as well. GFIG, $3.43, looks pretty good. We've got then the 200-day EMA at 366, and that also is some 363 was resistance before 366 here. So the first part just from where we have the between the two lines, and that would be a sufficient trade right there. But if it breaks above, then again, some new trend may be developing. GTIV over $6.82 up to the 728 would be the first start. Had increasing volume on Friday as well. IGT, of course, by the way, you know all these charts are on the watch list page where you can actually click and bring the charts in the view. So we're just kind of going through them quickly. IGT. Over this flag, can't say an exact amount, maybe 15.25. If volume is screaming and it gets to that 15 and change, 15.25, that area, then it has 15.40 resistance, and then the 15.62 is the 200-day EMA. So 15.25, 15.62, 15.62 is the start of a trade there, and if it fails, you still can exit if you need to with profits. But it's a pretty nice-looking flag, and hopefully it breaks on the upside, not on the downside. JRCC over $3 and something. Let's see it. It's coming up. Come on. $3.45 was its little high there recently. So what are we going to say? $3.45. Then it has $3.58 above it. But the main thing, it had big volume in this consolidation here. And if coal starts moving, this is a nice, looks pretty nice. It's moved up nicely from 190 to 345. That's a nice move. It could continue higher. If it then breaks above the 358, look for the 425 area. LEE's next up. And this time, another, now this is really low volume, but it was interesting looking chart. So be aware that low volume, you know, it was 340 shares, but sometimes it's a lot less than that. But a break over that 143 area could be interesting percentage-wise, because if it got going, maybe it could get up that 157. Of course, it could fail right there as well, and that's the whole point, isn't it? If it breaks over, people want to jump on board because it did not fail. I mean, we hopefully, that's the psychology behind it. And then we have TRIP. Over $46.10, that was as high. It did break above that 45.82 on Friday. It couldn't hold it, so that technically was a failure. But it had good volume, not quite double what it normally is, but a good volume on it, a 3.6 million shares. So hopefully it will try again and this time succeed. So that's what we have to start off this week. Hope you have a great day trading. Thanks a lot for watching. We'll send out tweets during the day, so pay attention to those before the market opens as well. Otherwise, we'll be back again tomorrow with some new ideas in Market Wrap. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.